and a loss to play these
Ooh.
Well.
Annie is in.
I finally
get
did it!
To see Annie in the mid lane. I love it.
Offensive ward here to watch the exit from Raptors. CoreJJ is going to get spotted and try brush.
Big damage, doesn't find the W knockback though, so CoreJJ is really in danger. This is going to be a lot of damage. Rugs him forward, exhaust comes out on tactical, still trying to hit Lost. Won't have enough damage to kill though, as Speak is coming back around, and this could be forced flashes. Body slam, the mana is low for Sword Art, but with a biscuit should have enough. Double stun comes across the slow as well. Flash tactical could be too late. Rockjump's going to find it and show him how it's done. Lost rocket jumps in for a double kill.
If you don't preemptively flash to make sure the tether doesn't break. So he's not going to have that added threat to his first ultimate when he does go for it.
Ooh. That's a flash engage! Calling is beautiful! And it's already 4-0 TSM! So engage had the ulti up. Gangplank cast it. Turns out Peewee could have been killed, but now, all right, here's the play. Speaker has flash and does not get away. Flash to follow, not required. Nocturne's move speed high enough with the Q.
That play and the pressure from Lucian, they just give the entire bottom lane here. That explosive charge actually finishes it off. First turret gold to Woo! TSM.
6-10.
Full gold, all in the lost pockets on top of the first two kills. This Tristana is going to be the terror of Summoner's Rift.
And mid's gone too. This is like just the charge. Okay, it's dead. There you go. 540 on the Power of Evil. This game is, you know, the obviously crushing defeat from a couple weeks ago when they dropped the TL. It was a early exit in the lock-in tournament on top of that one.
Yeah, Rift Herald on top side, Procket on this tower. It's just the towers are just falling like dominoes here, and then they can easily transition over Ooh. To pick up the dragon
they
in
can
time.
Sleep them. Is there the engage on CoreJJ explosive cask? Maybe, yes. Flash and
oh,
with kill the Gale Force
guard right now. I agree. And the bus looks like it wants to end at the Nexus. This second tower also going to go down. Hootie's here.
Flash Mega Gnar double kill is going to be an easy one. The rocket belt backwards. Nah, it's still going to be enough. How about the re-engage though? Any damage to be seen? Yes, there is a trade kill. One picked up, but it's going to be his death all the same. And now it's time to run back away. Alfari just going to on TSM side. And certainly comebacks can happen. Yes, mistakes can be there and big plays can show up. It's just a lot to do. Speaker allowed to solo the second dragon now of the game.
About it, Delusion into, oh, okay. Well, that's the end of that. Nothing yep. comes from it. Team Liquid just absolutely obliterated mid lane. Sword Art, so many plays, controlling the bottom side of the map.
The shock off. Yeah, he's got Locket, but he's not that tanky. He's only armor stacking. There's actually almost no bonus MR in his build. CoreJJ gonna go for that engage, gonna go for the stun, and the entire team is here. They found the first kill, looking out for the second. CoreJJ gonna get killed off, but it's a 2-for-1 to start. The engage is found. Time for number 3. Lost barely flashed away to safety, but there's the Gragas down. 3 kills answered by 1, and Lost.
Ooh.
Armeo could be in range, has to be careful. He'll live. This will not kill him, the explosive charge, but yeah. Spell shields it, no problem. Can they even Baron,
Opening.
Though? It's a 4v2, but Huni can maybe build a Mega Gnar and maybe make it just not possible. And ultimately, yeah, it's just the +2 kills.
To ever fight this dragon, instead trying to get a trade on the other side of the map. You don't want to inefficiently allocate your resources, staring down something you're not going to go for.
Can end this game, but oh my gosh, the 80 carries. I mean, lost on 3 full items. And Tactical has a last whisper, but it's enough to completely, instantly shut down Tristana. And the next one's going to be free as well. The sleep's not dropping fast. Huni does not have Mega Gnar. Smite is going to be up in about 2 seconds. They got to wait. They got to lower the damage up until Smite comes back up. And it's going to be claimed now. The re-engage happens. 5v3. Huni hits Mega. Hits 3. Is it even going to be enough, though? It's already 2 kills. And it's going to be the delayed ace. Power Evil running away. The barrels may not land. He will not find that kill. But no, the flash forward. Not going to be enough. Jump away is Power of Evil.
All this extra gold from all these shutdowns has almost brought them back to an equivalent level as well.
And they're trying. That is what they picked it for. That's what they're hoping to do with this draft, the instant deletion. And just like that, TL are back in this game. They're still down in gold, Kobe. They're still down in gold after the kill, after the Baron, after the turret goes down. Yeah, this Rebel Baron is going to be gigantic, you know, 5,000-6,000 at the end of the day. That only claws them back to equal as far as the gold is concerned. Based on the fights, they didn't eat it in the first place.
I mean, the burst potential there, too.
So Jensen's stun is charged. The ultis are up basically across the board, but a smite fight is important. It's Ocean Soul Point, and Alfari is down below 1,000 health. Nocturnal comes in, big damage on Gragas. They go for the engage, they reach backline, and here comes the team fight. Lust, staying alive, gets the first shutdown, and he's still up. CoreJJ easily chased, 2-0. TSM find the team fight, and the barrel chain doesn't find the kill. Health bar still low, Jensen's gotta be careful. Meganar turns back off, and Alfari, now unstoppable. They're gonna find Lust as well in the backline. Is Huni, and he cannot kill Jensen. Annie is just too good, but a bowling ball finds a second. 12-3 the kill score, 2 for TSM, 2 for TL, and there's only a smite for both these junglers. One level lead here for the Nocturne. Is it gonna be enough? You cannot hide Dragon inside a brush. He's gonna block them. Oh, let's go, Armeo. He finds one, and he might try to find Speak, but he's running so fast, he's prancing.
Fully just running right back over it. They lost all towers leading up to their inhibitor turrets, all of their jungle, all of these neutral objectives up until now. And yet, when the soul matters, Armeo comes up huge, steals it away from them. All the shutdowns have been cleaned off the side of the TSM scoreboard there, Freak. Not gonna give them any time. TSM starting it up. They are a bit desperate. Can he get inside the bit? All they need is some vision.
Okay, they pop it, hard engage, record today, finds three timbers over the top. The backline engage is not yet a kill, but they find one, they find two, and TL are just wiping the floor with TSM. Sword Art's on the run, Sword Art is done, and Huni is the only one left alone to watch as his teammates have died. Armeo stops the recall, and TL, they don't want the Baron. It's punished them before. They want the base. They want to close out game two.
Yep, Armeo gonna go toe-to-toe with his old teammate, Huni here. Can he get this? Spear is in range!
And he's gonna do a whole bunch of damage. It might not be enough.
Vega.
Who cares? He's stopping recalls. Stopping recalls is all that matters because the team is in the base. This is the best death I've ever seen from Armeo. The best lost 1v1 because the Nexus turrets have fallen. And from an impossible position, Team Liquid pull the comeback and take game two over TSM.